Hi everyone, welcome back. My name is Pooja Rawat and this is our current affairs series for the agriculture and rural development for the NABARD exam. Alright, so we are covering the current affairs for the month of July. And yeah, before we begin, all those people who are here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon so that you don't miss on the upcoming videos. And you can also join our Telegram group wherein you can discuss among the peers, you can post your queries and you'll be updated with the upcoming videos and the latest exam notifications. So let us start our session. This is the first question and it says, choose the correct statement with respect to National Farmers Database. So this is a database wherein the land records of the farmers would be collected or would be stored. Alright, so digitalized land records जो होंगे उसका database है this national farmer database. Alright, and this has been recently been talked by the agriculture minister in the parliament by the end of this July only. Alright, so here are these statements you need to identify which of these are correct. First one is the aim or the purpose is to increase the income of the farmers by leveraging the available data and developing solutions based on this data. So the farmers data will be recorded, farmers land records, digitalized land records would be collected, right? And based on these datas, the farmers are trying to leverage this data, to use this data to increase the income of the farmers through different provisions, right? So National Farmer Database Canada, there will be different provision, there will be different services to be provided to the farmers based on the land data or the land records of these farmers. Alright, so the final or the ultimate purpose is to increase the income of farmers. Alright, second statement hai, digitalized land records will be used as the data attributes for the creation of a farmers database. This one is also correct. Excuse me. So the data hai, wo data kis tarike ka hoga? These are the digitalized land records of the farmers, alright. Now the third statement is, the database will include not only the farmers who are the legal owners of the agricultural land, but also the landless farmers. This one is wrong, because presently this database will consist of only the land records of the farmers who are the legal owners, alright. So landless farmers ke liye yahan pe koi bhi place nahi hai. Only the farmers who are the legal owners, their database would be included in this National Farmers Database. Alright, so this would be a federated farmer database at the national level. Alright, so third statement is wrong and the correct option here would be first and second only. A would be the correct answer. Now this is about the National Farmers Database. So it will consist of a country's digitalized land records. We know that. Digitalized land records would be collected here in this database and this will aid in the online sign-on, single sign-on facilities for the universal access. Alright, so there will be, this will be an online database, alright, and the farmer could access it through a single sign-on process. Alright, the aim is to increase the income of farmers, alright, by using this data and by developing solution or by developing the personalized solution as per the farmers' problems or the farmers' concerns. Alright, now what are the services that would be offered to the farmers through this database through utilizing or leveraging this data? Personalized services such as soil and plant health advisories. Alright, so land records and digitalized land records would be collected, they would be geotagged. So yahan pe kya hoga, soil conditions ko dekhte hue, plant health ko dekhte hue, there would be advisories would be issued to these farmers regarding to the soil and the plant health. Then the DBT, direct benefit transfer facilities, then irrigation facilities, seamless credit and insurance facilities, then seed supply, pesticide related information, fertilizer related information, the nearby logistic facilities for the transportation of the final crop or produce, alright. Then peer-to-peer lending of farm equipment. Since the majority of the farmers are the small and marginal, it would not be economical for farmers to buy farm equipments, alright. So they can lend among themselves, alright. And this database would also provide information related to the market access, alright. Now the database will include only the farmers who are the legal owners. सो एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड, जो फार्मर्स लीगल ओनर हैं लैंड के, दे विल बी इंक्लूडेड इन दिस डेटाबेस. ऑलराइट, लैंडलेस फार्मर्स विल नॉट बी इंक्लूडेड. सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दिस. मूविंग फॉरवर्ड टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, फूड एंड एग्रीकल्चर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन रिसेंटली पब्लिश्ड इट्स स्टेट ऑफ फूड सिक्योरिटी न्यूट्रिशन इन द वर्ल्ड 2021 रिपोर्ट. Right, so this report was being published by this FAO organization. All right, and according to it, first statement is there is a decrease in the affordability of the healthy food because of the loss of income. So it has been seen that in the previous year, owing to the pandemic situation, a lot of people lost their job. All right, so there was a loss in income, and thereby it has been seen that there was a decrease in the affordability of healthy food. So healthy food kya hota hai, healthy food not only take care of the essential nutrients jo ki hame staple food se milte hain, but it is a balanced diet, it is a diversified diet in which a person has access to different sort of diet, like there will be a diversification in the availability of foods in the crops like pulses or the vegetables or the fruits, the grains. Alright, so there will be a diversification, and it will be a balanced diet. Alright, in terms of proteins or carbs or the calories, vitamins, minerals. So this diet would provide everything related to it. Alright, will provide complete nutrition. Now the second, this one is correct. Alright, so there was a decrease in the affordability of the healthy food. Second statement is 12% of the global population saved severe food insecurity. So this one is also correct. So in the 2021, around 12% of the people around the world faced the severe food insecurity. They were not able, or they were not able to afford food. All right. So both of these statements are correct. The correct option would be C here. Moving forward to the third question. Recently, Project Bold is being launched in Rajasthan. Which of the following is true with respect to it? So, Project Bold jo hai, wo first statement dekh lete pehle. It is launched by Khadi and Village Industries Commission, which is KVIC, in collaboration with the Border Security Force. So, this one is correct. So, under this Project Bold, 1,000 sampling of bamboos were planted in the Rajasthan, Jaisalmer district mein. Alright, so it has been seen that there is a problem of desertification in the Jaisalmer areas. So KVIC has taken this initiative along with the BSF Border Security Force to plant this bamboos, alright, 1,000 samplings of bamboos to increase the green cover, to reduce the desertification. Alright, and this will also increase the income of the local people. Alright, so this 1,000 samplings, it's suggested, or it's estimated to give an income of around 5 lakh, and that income could be utilized for the overall development of the local community. Alright, so this one is correct. Now the second statement is, it aims to provide livelihood, alright, reducing desertification and providing multidisciplinary rural industry support to the local population of the area. This one is also correct. Why? So we know that bamboos jo hai in ye kis tarike se hoti hai, soil erosion ko rokti hai, then water availability ko increase karte hai. So this will reduce the desertification, and it will also provide the livelihood opportunities to the local people, because bamboos has many uses. Theek hai, to bamboos ko aap kis tarike se utilize kar sakte hain? It can be used to make furniture, you know, furniture banaya ja sakta hai. Then bamboos can also be used to make agarbattis, right? So there are different uses, or different small businesses could be established by utilizing these bamboos. All right, so this one is also correct. It aims to provide livelihood, this will reduce desertification, and will provide a multidisciplinary rural industry support to the local people of the area. So both of these statements are correct, and the correct option would be C here. All right, and yeah, so remember this BOLD jo hai project hamara ka, it stands for your bamboo oasis on lands in drought. All right, So these bold का मतलब क्या? Bamboo oasis on lands in drought. So the lands which are prone to drought condition or desertification condition, therein this bamboo oasis would be created. An area that would be planted with the bamboos would be created to reduce this desertification. Okay, so this stands for bamboo oasis in the land of drought. Now, question number fourth is, consider the following statement with respect to golden rice. So I think we have already discussed about the golden rice in one of our previous session, but this was again in the news, right? So let us take these statements. First statement is, India is the first country that allowed its commercial production. This one is false, because Philippines is the first country that has allowed its commercial production, all right? So RRI, which is the International Rice Research Institute, has been working on this golden rice development, all right? And finally, the Philippines has allowed its commercial production. So Philippines has become the world's first country to allow its commercial production. Now, second statement is, it has the potential to combat childhood blindness in the developing regions of the world. Now, the importance of the golden rice is, it is rich in vitamin A. Okay? So, blindness kis wajah se hoti hai? Due to the deficiency of vitamin A. So, since golden rice is rich in vitamin A, it can easily, or it has the potential to combat the childhood blindness. So, this one is correct. Alright? See, ordinary rice grain जो हमारा होता है, normally जो rice plant होगा, so photosynthesis का process इस तरीके का होता है, क्योंकि जो rice plant होता है, उसके plant में तो आपको beta carotene मिलता है, which is a component of vitamin A, but grain में वो nutrient available नहीं होता, ठीक है? Grain में नहीं है, plant में है, but grain में नहीं है, so this is a genetically modified rice, ठीक है? So this has been genetically modified so that the grain of the rice plant could be made rich in the beta carotene, which is the component of vitamin A. So this golden rice ke jo grain honge, this will be rich in vitamin A, and it can aisa nahi hai ki isme extra kuch effort lag raha hai cultivate karne mein, it would require the same amount of irrigation or same amount or same type of fertilizers that has been continuously being used for the ordinary rice cultivation. Alright, so golden rice cultivate करने में as such कोई problem नहीं है, but since it is a GM crop, genetically modified crop, so there has been a lot of opposition regarding the environmental impact of the golden rice. Alright, in fact, not about the golden rice, all the GM crops faced a lot of opposition from the people around the world. Alright, so Philippines has allowed its commercial production, and it has a potential to combat the childhood blindness. So both of the first statement is wrong, and only the second statement is correct here. Now the last question of today's session is, consider the following statement with respect to monk fruit. So the name is derived or the name has been such this monk fruit because the monks were the first people who actually utilized this fruit, all right? And this is a Chinese fruit or of Chinese origin, China origin. Okay, so we have imported 50 samplings of this fruits sampling from the China, and this has started being cultivating in the Kullu, Himachal Pradesh. Okay, so first statement hai aapka, cultivation of monk fruit from China has started in Kullu, Himachal Pradesh, and it is famous as the natural caloric non-caloric natural sweetener. So this one is correct. So it is famous for its properties of non-caloric natural sweetener. This is a natural sweetener, but it has no calories. All right. So this has recently been started in cultivating in Kullu, which is in Himachal Pradesh, and it is under the field trial. Okay, field trial mein hai ye. Abhi iska commercial cultivation nahi ho raha hai. It is under the field trial. And second statement hai, it may give the economic benefit of up to rupees 3 lakh to 3.5 lakh per hectare. This one is correct, right? So monk fruit ki properties or why we are trying to grow these crops in the Indian scenario or on the Indian land, because first it can give the benefit of up to 3 to 3.5 lakh per hectare, which is a huge amount seeing the nature of the farmers, found in the Indian subcontinent, all right? So Indian country mein kya, India country mein, there are 85% are, in fact 86% are the small and marginal farmers, all right? To increase their income, to give them the sustainable secondary income, it would be beneficial to give promotion to the allied activities, to give promotion to the fruit cultivation or the vegetable cultivation, aromatic plants, medicinal plants, all right? And government is trying to promote all these crops, all right? So first thing is that it can give the economic benefits. Second, it is a natural sweetener and it has no calories there. Thereby, its export potential is can also be very huge, all right? So both of these statements are correct, and the correct option here would be C, all right? So remember this. All right, so this was all about today's session. I hope you like it. In case you have any queries, do post it down on the comment section. All right, we'll see you in the next session. Till then, keep working hard, keep studying. Goodbye.